guys, it's Linda here and I'm finally back with a new tutorial slash review slash honest opinion over this beauty right here. I am so excited because I've been waiting to do a look with it, but I couldn't really think of what look to do. So I'm gonna first do a look. I'm not sure what exactly I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna go with it. And then towards the end, I will definitely let you know my honest opinion, thoughts about the pigmentation and everything, the whole palette, everything. So if you want to know, stay tuned, and I'm gonna be creating something awesome with this beautiful palette. So stay tuned and see what I come up with. So I'm gonna be going in with these two shades first as my transition shades. And I will pop a little bit of this one as well. So I'm going to start with these two shades and working them in my crease, going back and forth. And this will be my transition. And I'm going to go in with these two shades right here, this lighter brown and this darker reddish brown. And I'm also going to apply that in my crease. I'm going to mix them together, and I'm going to use this Morphe 518 brush for that. So I'm applying this right here on the outer of my crease, warming up the color and bringing it forward. And I'm going to keep doing that until I get that desired shade, opaque, whatever you call it. Now I'm going to be going in with this purple shade right here. I'm not going to lie, I am a little scared, but let's see what happens with it. And I'm going to be using the Morphe M433 brush. Ooh, there we go. I'm going to apply this right in my crease. Oh, that's really pigmented. Not going to lie, I'm a little scared and skeptical about it because it is shimmery. Hopefully it won't be so hard to blend it out. And I'm gonna start right here, tight in the crease only, and then going back and forth and blending it. And I'm gonna add as I need until I am satisfied with how much shadow is in there. Start right here and bringing it forward. And then blending it. Make sure you don't blend it upwards too much. Just stay in the crease. Wow, shockingly, I don't see any fallout. And I was really, really scared about this purple shade. It's very shimmery. I love this brush. It really gets into the crease and it helps you just stay in that area and just blend it out. I love this. Such a beautiful purple. And now I'm going to go in with this blue. This blue shade is beautiful. I think it's like my favorite shade in the palette. So I'm also going to apply that in my crease with the same brush that I was using prior, the M433. So I'm going to pick some up. Let's see if this one is just as good as the purple one. Here we go, right in the crease. So this one I'm going to take it just a little bit below the purple. See what this blue can do. Oh, she's pretty. So I'm just kind of like blending it in with the purple. Like I said, I don't know exactly what I'm doing. I'm just kind of going with it, and we'll see what comes out towards the end. Pray that it's something cute. And now I'm gonna go in with this matte shade right here first, and then after that I'm gonna apply this one on top of it, and let's see what comes out. I'm gonna use the same brush that I was using in the crease, and I'm gonna go with that matte teal. I'm just gonna pat it on the lid. This is a blending brush. So we'll see how that works with this. So I'm just patting it on the lid. Ooh, she's pretty. So now I'm gonna go in with this shimmery teal. And I am gonna wet my brush just because I do not know what to expect. And I'm gonna be wetting it with the MAC Fix Plus. And also I'm gonna be using this MAC 228 little brush to apply it on. So I'm gonna pick up some of the product, wet my brush. Ooh, let's see how this is gonna work out. Okay, so she's pigmented and beautiful. Oh, that's really pretty. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply it all over on top of that green teal matte that we had applied first. So now I'm gonna go in with this Artist Couture Diamond Glow Powder Mermaid Fantasy. And I'm gonna apply this right on top of my lid just to add a little extra . I'm gonna go in with this Baby Morphe M213 brush. And I'm just gonna grab some of that Diamond Glow Powder and just kind of put it on top just for some extra. Ooh, do you see that pop? I just have to take it there because why not? I'm definitely feeling like mermaid vibes right here, which I'm totally okay with. So now I'm just cleaning up a little bit of the fallout, which shockingly, I didn't have much, which is a really, really good thing. And now I'm gonna pop on a liner and some lashes and I'll be right back. I'm back. You see that's lashes? Aren't they beautiful? They are the Lilly lashes in the style Hollywood. So now I'm gonna go ahead and start with my face. I will be priming my face and I'll be using Professional by Benefit. This stuff is pretty amazing. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply a generous amount on my face to cover some of these pores. And also to act as my primer. We must pretty much massage it in, pat it in, whatever works best for you. After you prime your face, now I'm gonna have to apply some color corrector underneath these eyes. So these eyes are definitely dark. What I'm gonna be using is the Anastasia Cream Contour Kit in medium, and I'm gonna be using Warm Coral, which is on this side. Haha, I know, excuse, this looks really messy, but I will be using this one underneath my eyes, anywhere I need extra conceal. So I'm just gonna go ahead with my finger and just go ahead and work it in underneath my eyes. And this really, really helps me. Cause girl, you know, I got time for these dark circles. So now I'm gonna be applying foundation. For today, I'm gonna be using the Too Faced Born This Way foundation. Right now, currently, I am in the shade of golden because I am doing a self tanner. So I'm kind of just playing around with the colors. So I'm gonna do a few pumps on the back of my hand and go ahead and dot it out. And then I'm gonna be using the Morphe G1 to go ahead and work this into my skin. Oh, can't be having none of that out now. Underneath the eye, I'm just gonna just pat. This foundation, you know, my first time really trying it. Well, I've tried it before, but a few days before, and I'm still kind of getting used to it. It's growing on me. So make sure you bring the foundation down your neck just a little bit so it just blends in nicely with the rest of your skin so you ain't looking crazy, girl. Love this brush. Just buffs everything up really nicely and evenly. And for concealer, I'm going to be using the Shape Tape Concealer from Tarte. And my shade is in light medium because we got to get rid of these under eye. Kind of give us a little highlight. So I'm gonna apply this right underneath my eye. I like this. So I kind of like to do it in sections first. And then I'm gonna go in with my beauty blender and just blend it out. I don't do it like when I put this on the concealer actually. I don't like doing it right underneath there because I feel like it's just so much product. So I do it just right underneath. And then I just work the product in with my beauty blender. And I'm gonna apply some down my nose right here. And on the chin and just blend that out. I know, I look crazy. But it works. Sorry, I keep looking away. I'm just making sure that you can see and I'm not like hiding anything. Now that we've blended that all out, I'm gonna be grabbing my Laura Mercier translucent powder, which looks like this. My favorite, most favorite translucent powder ever. In the back of right here, make sure there's no crease in underneath the eyes, and we're going to be setting it. Because nobody has time for some creasing under those eyes, girl. Now I'm going to be setting the rest of my face with this Morphe E41 and some of the translucent powder just to kind of set everything else in place. You don't have to do this. I do because I have super oily skin and this just helps my skin look amazing, last longer, and just looks the bomb. Love this. I love this translucent powder. I've tried it pretty much every single one. And this is by far my most favorite one. Whichever translucent you have works. This is just my favorite. And now I'm gonna be finishing right underneath the eye, just to put the look together. So I'm gonna be using the same shades that I use in the transition to complete the look. So I'm gonna be with this little orangey taupey brown color first. I'm using this M506 blending brush. It's so cute and it's so little and it just works perfect underneath my eyes. So now I'm going to be applying some of the blue and purple that I have in the crease underneath my eye. And this is going to help everything come together. I'm going to put it really tight close to that waterline. And for this, I'm using the M432 brush. Just to give it a little pop, like that. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of the teal right really close to the waterline as well, just to connect it all together. Just add a little to it. And I know y'all are probably wondering what happened to my thumb. My nail broke, so I didn't want y'all to see that nasty nail. Sorry about that. And I'm gonna pop on some of that little shimmer highlight glow, diamond glow powder from Artist Couture Mermaid Fantasy right in the inner corners to give it that little extra pop that it needs. Do y'all see that? This is so giving me mermaid vibes. I'm obsessed over this look. And I didn't even have this plan, I just kind of went with it, and I'm really, really happy with it. And next, I'm going to be using this right underneath my brow bone as a highlight. So exciting to see what this baby can do. I'm using a MAC. I don't remember the brush number, but one of the MAC brushes, the flat ones. This is actually the Mariah Carey collection one. She's so pretty, look. Ooh. But I mean, look at this underbrow highlight, it is everything. Ooh. And I'm gonna be using this to bronze and also use as my blush. This is the Cheek Parade by Benefit. Look how beautiful she is. I'm gonna be using this shade right here, Cola, to bronze my face. And I'm gonna be using the Morphe R2. So let's see what we can do. I'm gonna bronze this face a little bit. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and bronze pretty much my cheeks, give it a little color, and then my forehead, because girl, I need to look a little bit bronzy. A little bit right here, just giving a slight chisel effect. Then I'm going to be applying this right here for my blush. What is it called? California? With this Luxe Large Angle Brush 504. Just give me a little bit of color. For my highlight, I'm going to be using this Highlight Opals from Lime Crime. And I'm going to be using Peach. I believe it's this one right here. So let's see what this baby can do. And this side. Now I really feel like I'm a mermaid. And I'm using this Morphe M510 as my highlighting brush. I'm gonna do a Cupid's bow. A little on the chin. A little bit of bow. Because why not? A little bit on the tip of the nose. Right down here. Do you see this highlight? Side view. Beautiful, huh? Well, let me just pop this lip on and I'll be right back. So pretty much this is the finished look. I'm just gonna set it with this Morphe Prep and Set. And oh my god, I love this. It smells amazing. We are set. So pretty much this is my finished look. What do y'all think? Give you a little side view. And then this side. I really, really hope you enjoyed this look. And now, what you've been waiting for, the review, the thoughts, the honest truth. Well, first let me tell you, I'm obsessed. I couldn't have been happier for this purchase. I love the palette. I don't care if it's white. I think it's beautiful. It is getting a little dirty, but hey, why? What's wrong with that? Also, this colors are everything. Like, you can do the warms, natural, everyday. You can have a little pop of color, a little smoky in there, a little bit of everything. I feel this palette is perfect for anybody. You have pretty much all ranges. The pigmentation is insane, out of this world. The color ones, I was actually really, really scared to put it in my crease, but I was very, very impressed. It was very easy to blend, super pigmented. And I barely had any fallout, which I was really scared because I was like, uh-oh, fallout is going to come out. But no. It was very, very, and very impressed for this palette. Do I recommend it? Yes, I do. So whenever they have a restock or whatever, make sure you get yourself one. But other than that, I give this 100. Woo! I'm obsessed. And this look, I mean, dang. So worth it. So try to recreate this look and tell me what you think in the comments below. If there is another look or something else you want me to try, let me know. I will be doing some more reviews on new products, so stay tuned for that. And other than that, hope to see you soon.